Hey, what is up everybody? Jason here. Today we are going to be taking a look at my latest kinetic sculpture slash automaton, which is this model of a figure repeatedly picking up these balls. Conceptually, it is pretty simple, but in reality, there is quite a bit going on, not only to grab, lift, and release the balls, but also to make the movement of the figure as natural looking as possible. When I first started working on this model, I was solely focused on the mechanics. And this is one of the first prototypes I designed to test out the grab and release mechanism. As you can see, it is very rough around the edges, but it worked well enough to convince me it was worth continuing on. My original goal was just to build a GBC module, and I really had no idea how it would be styled, whether it would just be a machine or a robot, or even if I would have multiple copies of this mechanism in sequence or stacked on top of each other to pass the balls between them. Eventually, I experimented with kind of skinning the mechanism with a humanoid figure, as I do seem to have a habit of creating large figure kinetic sculptures. And here is an early prototype of that. Note, in this version, there's only a single arm and a leg in front of the mechanism. In order to add space for the other arm and leg, I had to bring the grabbing arm out from the wall, and it essentially operates through the torso of the figure now, which you can see in the finished model. I also really wanted the movement of the figure to be as natural looking as possible, and for that I actually used myself as a subject. I would literally put an object on a chair in front of me and analyze how I would pick it up and place it on a shelf above me. And this was particularly helpful in refining the movement of the torso. In this prototype, you can see that the torso leans quite a bit forward when picking up and releasing the ball. And in the finished model, I added a pin on the left side of the body and a couple of control surfaces to constrain the movement of the torso. So instead of leaning forward at the extremes, the torso stops and the arms extend instead. It's a pretty subtle difference, but I do feel it adds to the realism of the movement. Eventually, I began to focus on what the finished model would look like, and I thought that in addition to a GBC module, it would be cool to have a standalone version as well that could be displayed on its own. And I went through several prototypes of each until I got to a design that I was finally happy with. The standalone version is themed as an industrial environment where the figure can happily go about performing their work. I even added a fan to provide good ventilation, and the balls are cycled back down in the back with a stepper to ensure that they are released at the right time to be picked up. For the GBC module, I went with a much simpler design aesthetic. I really wanted to focus the viewer's attention just on the figure itself. I thought it would be interesting that in the enormous complexity that is a GBC layout, there is this lone figure tirelessly picking up each ball as it comes through. So, how does the model actually work? In both versions, the core mechanics are the same. There is a single motor in the back driving this piston, which oscillates these gears. The upper gear is connected to a point about midway along the arm, and the back of the arm slides through this channel. As a result, the front of the arm transcribes this nice arcing movement from the bottom platform to the top platform. The grabbing mechanism is essentially just a rocker switch so that as it's pushed a little bit one way or the other, the elastic band snaps it into the open or closed position. And it has a couple of control pins on it to facilitate that. As the arm reaches the top of its arc, one of those pins hits this control surface, causing the grabber to rock open. And as the arm reaches the bottom, the other pin hits this control surface, which causes it to rock closed. And to physically grab the ball, I'm just using a couple of 3x3 transparent radar dishes. The standalone version also has an additional piston off the same drive crank to control the ball return. As far as performance goes, I haven't tested it too extensively. I have run the GBC module at 1 ball per second for 45 minutes before it had a drop, which actually isn't too bad, I don't think, but definitely not 100%. Since there is no 1 ball per second requirement for the standalone version, it can be run a bit slower, which I think does seem to make it a bit more reliable. And that is about it for this one. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you next time.